Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. You know how we do it, another day, another scholarship. If you're new, thanks for joining us. If you're a returning viewer, thanks for coming back. So today we'll be looking at fully funded masters and PhD scholarships in Australia. So Australia has been out of the radar for a number of months, if not up to a year, for well-known reasons. And now the country has announced that it's about to be open, or is going to open quite soon. And trust me, I'm bringing you universities that are ready to accept students from as soon as the first quarter of next year. So we'll be looking at a number of universities in Australia who are already preparing to accept international students and through fully funded masters and PhD scholarships. So sit back, relax, while I show you available opportunities in Australia where you can study for free, including insurance, including monthly stipend. So let's begin without any further delay. So this is one of the universities we'll be looking at today. We have about six of them to look at today. And the first one is the University of Queensland, of course, in Australia. And the name of the scholarship is the RTP, Research Training Program, I believe that's the meaning. And it's usually funded by the Australian government in a number of Australian universities. And for this university, for the University of Queensland, this is just for a PhD, I believe. But I'll be showing you other universities where you have master's opportunities as well. So we'll quickly be looking at like dates, what the scholarships will cover, and other things, other important info like that. So for this scholarship, it covers a stipend of over $28,000, as you can see it here, tax-free. And also, you have overseas student health cover as well. So you don't need to worry about money because they got you covered, giving you tuition-free, as you can see here, and then living stipend scholarship. So you do not have to move any financial muscle. They also got you covered for health insurance. And it's a 3.5 years program, and it could be extended for another 1 year, as you can see. So this is the information about the lockdown and everything. And this has been here for a while and has not been updated yet. So you can always email the universities, always email professors, because since a number of universities have announced the opening of the universities and the end of restrictions, I think this might no longer apply. And if you look at the timetable as well, there's a timetable as well for international students. So this timetable is already late because it talks about opening in August 2021 and closing in September. August and September are past now. But if you look at the round two opens in February 2022. I think you can actually meet this one and closes in March 2022. So this is very doable. And by this time, I believe that all these restrictions, the closing of borders, must have been resolved by then. Well, how do you apply? This is a PhD program, a PhD scholarship, of course. So you need to look for a supervisor in the university, look for the eligible courses in the university, identify a supervisor whose research area excites you, who you want to work with, and send the person an email. And for a number of universities in Australia, they want you to come with your own research question or your own research topic. Then look for somebody in that department who can supervise that topic because of the person's areas of expertise. So if you're in the area of conflicts and global peace, for instance, you're going to this university looking for a professor in this area, then you pitch your idea to the professor, hoping that the professor accepts to, you know, take you in as a student. The other info here on how to apply and things like that, you can read on your own. But quickly, we'll take a dash to other universities with actually similar application requirements, I must say. So this is Griffith University. And as usual, pay attention to the dates. The intake here is February 2022, so it's enough time. There's another one in April, another one in July, another one in October 2022. So you have lots of time for this for this scholarship. And I think it's both for masters and PhD, or PhD and research degrees. That's a research master's. I've made this distinction in the past, the difference between a taught master's and a research master's. For a research master's, it's like a mini PhD. You're coming to the university, as I said some minutes ago, with a topic or with a question. Like you have like a short research proposal that contains the topic you're interested in, the questions you want to answer, and how you intend to answer these questions. Then you go to the department and look for professors who are ready to supervise you, even as a master's student. But for a taught master's, you go to class, you take a number of courses, and you take exams, probably a little research at the end, and go home. But for most of these scholarships I'll be showing you, you need to do a research master's and not a taught master's. There's another similar opportunity here at Monash University. They're paying $30,000, and this also covers things like apart from living allowance, things like insurance. Some people even say relocation fee. Just read closely what your scholarship covers, so you know exactly what you'll be getting. And as usual, research doctorate and research master's degree. The site contains other things you might be interested in as well. As you can see, both Australian and non-Australian residents or citizens are qualified. You see here international students, so they got you covered. The living allowance, relocation allowance as well, tuition cover. So guys, you have no problem when it comes to finances. So now we check the timetable. When are they accepting people? For international students, there's an application window from September to March. So September, let's say September 2021 closes in March 2022. So I think you can meet this deadline or this application period if you're serious about applying to Australia for fully funded research degrees. We also have the University of Melbourne, similar opportunities as well, fully funded, stipend, your insurance, and everything covered. Just make sure, I think the most important thing here is that you make sure you get a supervisor in this university. Getting a supervisor is the major task that you want to achieve, either as an incoming master's student or an incoming PhD student. And of course, here you can see living allowance here, they want 31,200, 31,200. That's even for 2021. It might even rise in 2022. So they got you covered. And relocation grant of 2,000 Canadian dollars. So you can see they got you covered through and through. And of course, overseas student health cover as well for international students. We still have another university here. This is the University of South Australia. And as usual, remember this word we talked about, or this term, research training program. You can find this in several universities, if not all universities in Australia. You can also compare and contrast what they'll be paying you every year. So this university says 28,854 Canadian dollars, not Canadian, sorry, Australian dollars. And you can see the duration of the course and every other thing you need to know. So you see similarities in these universities. There's another one here. This is the University of South Wales, I believe. And this is their own tuition. And this is how to apply. We could also look at the key dates for these scholarships, key dates, international students. So here it says March. You can see here. So take advantage of these dates and make sure you're not caught unawares. If none of these universities excited you, you can just go to Google and type RTP Australia, that's Research Training Program Australia. You see different universities offering this scholarship and offering similar benefits, full tuition, insurance costs, stipend, and even relocation fees. So you can check for the university whose package you're most interested in, or even apply to multiple universities. You might just be lucky as well. So that's it, guys. Australia is about to open, or probably might have opened as you're watching this video. So you want to probably send emails to professors, look for professors in these different universities, and pitch your research ideas to them. Fingers crossed, they find your proposal exciting and give you a place in one of these top universities in Australia. And that's it, guys. As usual, we cannot wait to celebrate you. Drop any questions you have in the comment section, and bye bye for now.